The return of reality behemoth Big Brother 9. Mikey, Mario, Rex, Darnell, Kathrea, they may all be unfamiliar names now, but by the end of the summer, they will have been etched into all our subconsciousnesses, because this select group are the housemates from this year's Big Brother. The show, which debuted on Thursday night, opened with over 5 million viewers. A big audience, but nearly a million less than last year's launch show.
She wanted to sleep in the other bedroom, just me and her. I said, well, there's a single bed. So I said, that isn't going to look right. A couple sleeping in another bedroom with single beds. I said, you're better just sleeping. If you want to sleep together or if you want to sleep with a girl, you can sleep with a girl.
Yeah.
I'm not bothered, as long as I get my head down.
Where are you planning to sleep tonight?
In the corner double bed.
With or without Mario?
With.
So, after 9 years, will the show that shocked, surprised and sparked debate around the world still have the power to attract large audiences? Or is Channel 4 flogging a dead horse? With me now, Phil Edgar-Jones, the producer of Big Brother at Brighter Pictures, and David Williams, who's Big Brother's commissioning editor at Channel 4. But let's start the discussion with Martin in the audience. Martin, where are you?
How are you doing?
What would you like to say?
I just think that the longer it goes on, the worse it's going to get. I mean, I think the reality shows, I think, are great. But they seem to be picking people that are trying to shock the nation.
Are you just a sort of a Big Brother hater?
I love Big Brother. I actually auditioned for Big Brother 4 years ago. I've got friends that have been on Big Brother and, you know, I love it. But it seems that the way that they're casting the people for the show, they're just trying to shock everyone. They're just, you know, how far can someone go before they get in trouble? How far can they go before people are going to say, look, you know, get rid of it?
OK. Phil Edgar-Jones.
I'm not quite sure what you mean by, you know, casting people that shock people. Who specifically?
The people that are going up for the auditions. I mean, it seems that you have to go a certain length, you know, do certain things, you know, turn up in extravagant. I mean, there's a girl auditioning in underwear. You know, it seems that the nation are coming in and having to be, you know, either make themselves out to be stupid or, you know, decide that they're going to have gay sex on TV or do something like that.
Okay, those things haven't happened.
It didn't start off like that.
I think, look, we don't have any massive theories behind our casting, I have to say. I mean, people come to us, we don't go looking for people. And what we try to assemble is a diverse bunch of people who are from different backgrounds.
There aren't any normal people, though, are there? There aren't any sort of people.
They're all normal people.
Like people you and I know normally.
Who isn't normal in there? I mean, and why aren't they normal?
They're all sort of a mixture of wannabes.
Are we saying that someone who's gay and from Edinburgh isn't normal? Are we saying someone who's blind isn't normal?
They're all exceptional characters, which is presumably why you've chosen them.
They're all interesting people with a bit of depth, and some of them are. But perhaps, yes, from the fringes of society. Some aren't maybe people you've necessarily seen on television before, but it's diverse. And I think, you know, there are enough people from different backgrounds in there that everyone can relate to.
And this year, of all years, we've been able to get 16, which is the most people we've ever had on the launch night going in. So I think this year, you know, more so than every other year, we've got something for everybody. Really.
OK. Sandra, you also had a problem with the launch night programme.
Yeah, basically, I think it's very immoral what you're doing. You know,
immoral?
Yeah, immoral, because you're putting Mario with Stephanie, obviously to cause friction with his current relationship with Lisa, on purpose just to get viewers' ratings to be higher. You know, unless they were put in that situation and basically forced to do that type of thing, they wouldn't normally do that.
OK, you think it's immoral?
Yeah.
OK, well, I mean, you know what? Big Brother is always, you know, we always introduce a series of twists and tasks along the way, and we always try to do stuff that's a wee bit outrageous. That's certainly true. Now, what I would say is that before anyone goes into the Big Brother house, they're fully, you know, checked out. We talk to them about how we're going to mess with their heads as we go along. I personally talked both to Mario and to Lisa before they went in. And I said, look, it's going to be tough on your relationship. We'll probably do things to mess around with you. Of course, we don't want to split people up on national television. And we know that their relationship is very strong and very robust. So we're playing with them. And they all accept that and they all know the game.
OK, well, we've got a lot of hands going up. I want to take some views from the floor in quick succession. Yes, in yellow.
I just think that it gives this incredible platform to people who largely don't have anything intelligent to say. Doesn't that worry you?
That's television, isn't it?
No.
OK, in the blue.
I was saying, you think it's immoral, but at the end of the day, people watch it. They don't have to do anything in the bed. All they're doing is sleeping with one another. Doesn't mean they have to do anything. Come on. People watch it when it's more quirkier. The fact that they've done this, people are going to be like, oh, what's going to happen next? It makes people want to watch it. And I personally am a big fan of Big Brother.
OK. I think it's top David, fan. I mean, is there a big idea this year? I mean, have you got a sense of what the narrative is supposed to be?
Well, we do always have a number of twists and turns with these guys, with Phil and their brilliant team, up our sleeve. But ultimately, we don't entirely know where it's going to go. And that's, for me, will always be the joy. We find these people, we try and find out as much about them as we possibly can. But ultimately, until we put them together in the same house, we don't really know where it's
going to
go. But
you got some press earlier this week claiming that, you know, that you were declaring war on wannabes. You got a house full of wannabes.
What we have said and we are aiming to do in this first night twist that we are just talking about is a prime example of, is getting this back to what it always was, which is a game show where people are tested and put under pressure.
OK, over here in the green.
Do you not think it's got to the point now where people who audition for Big Brother know that they've got to shock the people, you know, they know that they've got to be big and they've got to be a huge character to get in. So no one's genuine anymore. No one, you can't relate to them anymore because there's no one that's just in there being themselves. They're all putting on this huge show. And that means that, you know, it's just...
Phil, that's an interesting point.
I will say that's you know, it's certainly true. People come to auditions and they a lot of people try to be outrageous and to shock us, but we have an incredibly long audition process that gets beyond that, that gets under
people's
skin.
But she says she can't relate to them anymore.
Well, you have to. I think the people we've got in the house this year, if you stick with them a little while and you watch them, I think they have sort of genuine depth. They come from real places. A lot of them have real jobs.
Okay.
They're not just a bunch of people that are hanging around China Whites all the time.
I want to go to the phones now. Paula is on the line. Hello, Paula.
Hello.
What do you want to say?
I'd love to watch Big Brother, but unfortunately, Channel 4 has taken off the internet live streaming. For lack of demand, apparently. There's been a huge uproar about this and a massive response from fans demanding and willing to pay for this service.
Okay.
Are they going to do anything about it?
David, very briefly, why have you taken off the internet live streaming? Are you worried about being caught out, somebody saying dodgy?
Not at all. We still have live streaming available on Sky and on Virgin and on some mobile operators. And this isn't actually the first time we've done this. We didn't have live streaming on the website during Celebrity Hijack in January. And we used that opportunity... Well, we used that opportunity to refocus our resources elsewhere. We had far more clips on the website in Hijack in January. They were a fantastic success. We listened to people and we decided that we'd continue in this summer series.
Can I just get a quick show of hands here? Who's watching it? Who's not watching it deliberately? Oh, half and half. OK. Some of you still to be persuaded. Phil, give us anything. Tell us something that's going to happen that we haven't heard yet.
Oh, come on.
As if.
It's like the Secret Service. We can't give away Big Brother secrets.
But you're working on it.
Oh, we've got some things up our sleeve.
All right, thank you all very much indeed. We're going to leave it there.